Hello everyone, so in today's video we will see the first phase of revolutionary activities in the years 1907 to 1917. Radical trend towards military nationalism was seen in 1890s and it took a concrete shape in 1905 after the Bengal split. As an adjutant to this trend, a revolutionary wing also took place. The first phase acquired a more activist form as a fallout to the Swadeshi and boycott movement. This continued till the year 1917. The second phase started as a fallout to the non-cooperation movement in 1920s. The revolutionaries opted to follow the steps of Russian or the Irish nationalist. It included individual heroic action such as organizing associations of unpopular officials or traitors, Swadeshi dacoits to raise funds for revolutionary activities, during the First World War, organizing military conspiracies with the expectation to help from the enemies of Britain. The intention behind these activities was to strike terror in the hearts of the rulers, arouse people and remove the fear of authority from their minds. They also intended to inspire the people by appealing to their patriotism, especially the idealistic youth. Now we will look at the organizations which were responsible for these revolutionary activities. First was the Anushilan Samiti. It was the first revolutionary group which was organized in 1902 in Midnapore. In Calcutta, the Anushilan Samiti was founded by Pramotha Mitter, including Jatindranath Banerjee and Barindra Kumar Ghosh and others. The activities were limited to giving physical and moral training to the members and remained insignificant till the year 1907 to 1908. Under Anushilan Samiti in April 1906, a weekly Yugantar was started and conducted a few abortive actions. In December 1907, there were attempts to derail the train on which Lieutenant Governor Sir Andrew Fraser was travelling. In the year 1908, Prafulla Chaki and Khudiram Bose threw a bomb at a cartridge which was supposed to be carrying a particular sadistic white judge, Kingsford, in Muzaffarpur. But unfortunately, two British ladies instead got killed. Prafulla Chaki shot himself dead while Khudiram Bose was tried and hanged. The other individual heroic attacks by Anushilan Samiti were performed in the year 1908 and 1912. In 1908, Bara Dacoity was organized by Deka Anushilan under Pulin Das to raise funds for revolutionary activities. Also, in December 1912, Rajbihari Bose and Sachin Sanyal staged a spectacular bomb attack on Viceroy Hardinge while he was making his official entry into the new capital of Delhi. In Delhi conspiracy trial, at the end of the trial, Basant Kumar Biswas, Amit Chand and Awadh Bihari were convicted and executed. Also, Rajbihari Bose evaded the arrest because he escaped a donning disguise. In Alipore conspiracy case, the whole Anushilan group was arrested, including the Ghosh brothers, Aurobindo and Barindra. The Ghosh brothers were charged with the conspiracy or waging war against the king and punishable with death by hanging. Chitrandan Das defended Aurobindo. Aurobindo was acquitted of all the charges. In the form of Jatindranath Mukherjee or Bagha Jatin, the Anushilan Samiti founded a good leader and he emerged as the Jugantar or the Yugantar for the Samiti. Jatin revitalized the link between the central organization in Calcutta and other places of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. During the First World War, the Jugantar party arranged to import German arms and ammunition through sympathizers and revolutionaries abroad. Jatin also asked Rajbihari Bose to take charge of the Upper India, aiming to bring about All India insurrection in what has come to be known as द जर्मन प्लॉट और द जिमरमैन प्लान. द जुगांतर पार्टी ऑल्सो रेज फंड्स थ्रू अ सीरीज ऑफ डेकॉइट्स विच केम टू बी नोन एज टैक्सी कैब डेकॉइट्स और द बोट डेकॉइट्स. Unfortunately for the revolutionaries, the plot was leaked by one of the traitors and the German plot failed. As a result of this, Jatin Mukherjee was shot and he died a hero's death in Balasore on Odisha's coast in September 1915. The newspaper and the journals advocating revolutionary activities included Sandhya and Yugantar in Bengal. In Maharashtra, the first of the revolutionary activities was organized by Ramosi Peasant Force by Vasudev Balwant Phadke in 1879, which aimed to rid the country of the British by instigating an armed revolt and by disrupting communication lines. It hoped to raise the funds for its activities through dacoities and it was suppressed prematurely. In the 1890s, Tilak propagated a spirit of militant nationalism, including the use of violence, through Ganpati and Shivaji festivals, and also through his journals Kesri and Maratha. Two disciples of Tilak, Chapekar brothers Damodar and Bal Krishna, murdered the plague commissioner of Pune, Rand, and one lieutenant in 1897. The Savarkar brothers organized Mitra Mela, a secret society, in 1899, which merged with Abhinav Bharat after Mazzini's Young Italy in 1904. A.M.T. Jackson, a collector of Nasik, who was also a well-known ideologist, was killed by Anand Lakshman Kanheri, a member of Abhinav Bharat. In Punjab, the extremism was fueled by the issue such as frequent famines coupled with the rise of land revenue and also irrigation tax. Also the practice of Begar by Zamindar and by the events in Bengal. Among those who were active in Punjab were Lala Lajpat Rai, who brought out Punjabi with its motive of self-help at any cost, and also Ajit Singh, Bhagat Singh's uncle, who organized the extremist Anjumane Mohisban of Watan in Lahore with its journal Bharat Mata. Extremism in Punjab died down quickly after the government struck in May 1907 with a ban on political meetings and deportation of Lala Lajpat Rai and Ajit Singh. The revolutionaries also participated actively from abroad. The need for shelter and possibility of bringing out revolutionary literature that would be immune from the press and the quest for arms took Indian revolutionaries abroad. In London 1905, Shyamaji Krishna Verma started India Home Rule Society or India House as a center for Indian students. A scholarship scheme was also brought for radical youth from India and a journal, The Indian Socialist. The Savarkar brothers and Lala Hardayal became the members of India House. Also, Madan Lal Dhingra from this circle assassinated the India office bureaucrat of Curzon Willy in 1909. Also, certain new centers emerged at Paris and Geneva, from where Madame Bhikaji Kama, a Parsi revolutionary who had developed contact with French socialists and who brought out Bande Mataram, and Ajit Singh operated. And after 1909, when Anglo-German relationship deteriorated, Virendranath Chattopadhyay chose Berlin as his base. There were other centers like Swadesh Sevak Home at Vancouver and United India House at Seattle. Finally, in 1913, the Gadar was established. The Gadar Party was a revolutionary group organized around a weekly, the Gadar. Its headquarters was at San Francisco and the branches along with US coast and far east. These revolutionaries included mainly ex-soldiers, the peasants who had migrated from the Punjab to USA and Canada in search of better employment opportunity. The Gadar program was to organize assassination of officials and also to publish revolutionary and anti-imperialist literature. They worked among Indian troops stationed abroad, procure arms, and bring about a simultaneous revolt in all the British colonies. The moving spirit behind Gadar Party were Lala Hardayal, Ramchandra, Bhagwan Singh, Kartar Singh Saraba, Bakhtullah, and Bhai Parmanand. These revolutionaries intended to bring about a revolt in India. Their plans were encouraged by two events in 1914, the Komargatta Maru incident and the outbreak of the First World War. Europe also had some taste of these revolutionary activities with the Berlin Committee for Indian Independence, which was established in 1915 by Virendranath Chattopadhyay, Bhupendranath Datta, Lala Hardayal, and the others with the help of German Foreigners Office under Zimmermann Plan. Among the scattered mutinies during this period, the most notable one was in Singapore in February 1915 by Punjabi Muslims, also 5th Light Infantry and the 36th Sikh Battalion under Jamadar Chishti Khan, Jamadar Abdul Ghani and Subedar Daud Khan. It was crushed after a fierce battle in which many were killed. Later, 37 persons were executed and 41 transported for life. There was a temporary respite in revolutionary activities after the First World War because of the release of prisoners held under the Defense of India rules, and it cooled down the passion a little bit. There was an atmosphere of conciliation after Montagu's August 1917 statement. Also, the talk of constitutional reforms and the coming of Gandhi on the scene with the program of non-violence and non-cooperation promised a new hope. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful for you. For more videos, please subscribe our channel.